I watch the rain every time now because it was beautiful when I was still very young, and I'm 78 years old. I have the age of the Pope. And then also Dr. Ray is from, actually from San Pablo. No, from San Pedro. Pablo, St. Peter, Paul. And Dr. Susan Reyes is from Binyan. This is for us, our modest contribution to the evangelizing process that's going on in here in San Pablo. And I would like to say from the very beginning that this whole process is already an evangelizing activity. Hopefully that it will evangelize the participants and at the same time us, because we are always doing that kind of an accompaniment since 1963. 1963, we started with a request of the embassy fathers in Iloilo. We had the first survey that we did, socioeconomic potentials of Antique, in order to establish cooperatives. At that time, we did not call it accompaniment, but it was something like that. And then in 1965, we were asked by the Marymount Fathers to study the socioeconomic potentials of Northern and Eastern Davao. And at that time, the basic Christian communities were starting in Mindanao, and it dovetailed, the cooperatives that we started dovetailed with them, with the basic Christian communities, which was formerly a kind of a change in the content of the basic Christian communities, because it was formerly a barangay San Virgen. There were many activities at the barangay, so it was a popular religiosity which the Marymount Fathers transformed into the content of it to become the first basic Christian communities in Mindanao. After that, the Cotabato, Bishop Munjo asked us to study all his social, evaluate his socioeconomic projects. As you remember, older Carabaos were tattooed. The Carabao dispersal, older Carabaos were tattooed, male and female, with Notre Dame, Our Lady. Our Lady of Notre Dame. And then after that, Agusan followed. Agusan, the pastoral, we made a pastoral survey for their pastoral plan. And then we did accompany still north, Nueva Segovia, Nueva Cáceres, and yeah, that's right. Mountain Province, the CICM Fathers, who were at that time the one running the Mountain Province. And then when the CICM left, Kalapan, that's right, Mindoro. When we had Bishop with us, he was still a priest then, just for once to minister. And then right now we have the Bicol. It first started with the Prelature of Lumanan, a kind of a breakaway, not really that, but the diocese was divided into two, and that half of the diocese, they had not too many resources, but what they had was good, because then all the young priests were very open to change. And we guided them for 10 years. And right now, there are 3,600 family clusters in the diocese. We call it, the whole diocese has a basic ecclesial community culture. All their decrees are to support the basic Christian community. So they have 3,600 family clusters penetrating 11 municipalities. 375 barangays and all 28 parishes. But the one who spearheaded it, the bishop, passed away, and we have now Bishop Jerry Rojas, who said that when I came to Limanan, I came upon the Church of the Poor, not to any credit of mine, but to the former bishop, Bishop Prospero Arellano, who said in that whole process, he unlearned so much and was very dedicated to that whole process. Then it was copied by Masbate, but here we found that you cannot really duplicate a process in another diocese because of a different context. And then after 2 years, we stopped, we followed the Bishop Bong, and now with the help of Missio Munich, we are assisting five dioceses in Bicol, that is Caceres, Legazpi, Sorsogon, Masbate, and Catanduan, and Dirac Catanduanes. And so that way, and now we are here. So we really have to see to it that we too have to pray a lot so that the Spirit will help us facilitate this whole process. And that, and it is good that we actually had already a training of 56. In the beginning it was 64, isn't it? 64 participants, I think at least 4 from each vicariate here. There are 12 vicariates here, and I heard that each vicariate has at least about 8 parishes. Now this is a big process because your diocese is quite big. It's quite big. And that, therefore, that since it's a 2-year process, and so theorizing from all our experiences, we have developed a kind of a framework of what to make understandable what is that diocesan accompaniment and what are the learning components in this diocesan accompaniment. And I would like now, I forgot to say that ASI is a graduate school for economics, so offering masteral degrees in economics, sociology. There is still sociology major in transformative politics, education, extended by Dr. Linda Cierto, education major in transformative leadership and community development. And we have pastoral sociology for the professional for the professionalization of church workers. We have pastoral studies, and we have economics major in community economics. And then we have Master of Science in Social Work. We have a bachelor's degree in social work, but for those who already had a first degree. So we have journalist social worker, economist social worker, because they should have a bachelor's degree. And after that bachelor's degree, we give them one year and 2 summers to be able to get the bachelor's degree so that they can get the licensure exam. We have also master in social services and development, and we have only one doctoral program, which is kind of a holistic approach to social transformation, taking elements from natural sciences, social sciences, metaphysics, and spirituality, creation spirituality. And this doctoral degree has been quite appealing to so many professionals even if they have a doctoral degree, they would like, so that at one time, I had more students in the doctoral program than in any of the master's degree. But right now, still, the social work has the biggest number of participants. Okay. And then we have a short-term course, which is also a kind of a flagship program, 2 months intensive, where all the elements of the graduate program will be part of the curriculum, but very much applied to the grassroots level. And our aim in ASI is to produce leaders for different institutions, social development managers, social pastoral leaders in different institutions, so that when they make decisions in these institutions, the marginalized and the poor are the frame of reference. And that's why the exposure and immersion program among our students is an integral component and pedagogy of Asian Social Institute to transform the mindsets, so that the poor will be their frame of reference when making decisions. And therefore, corollary to that, when we are working with the grassroots, what we try to do is to self-empower, facilitate the self-empowerment of people. We don't empower because we believe that the God-given gifts in every person are already implanted in their hearts. And what we do is to try to make them blossom, to the point that we have farmers and young farmer leaders who can talk to the bishops, businessmen's conference. Now with the Year of the Poor, what we want as a social science graduate school is to form and train grassroots social scientists. Grassroots social scientists, and I think it is very possible, because we have proven already that we did an instrument on measures of well-being, which had the participation, and a very important participation, of pedicab drivers in Manila, who now we train also as interviewers for the people of the streets, you know. So that is Asian Social Institute. And out of all these experiences, we have come to a framework of what we call components of learning in the social pastoral cycle, or what Dr. Linda would say, spiral, the social pastoral spiral. Okay, and therefore I would like to be very brief, but I think you will understand it. You yourself will be able to elaborate on it as you experience trying to evangelize